still a good out of the ring.
Oh, he's lost.
Let it go like a man.
Can I not keep a scream
or something? Let it go like
a... The Giant had the opportunity to chokeslam Hollywood Hulk Hogan if only he had taken it. Hi, everyone. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbysko and the American dream Dusty Rhodes, here on WCW Pro on TBS, and what a sight it would have been if the Giant had chokeslammed Hollywood Hulk Hogan, Dusty.
Let me tell you what, guys. Last night on the mothership, I talked an awful lot about the Giant and everybody getting wrapped up in a big event. Something special happened. Then you want to be that person. You want to be that icon. The Giant won the right at that 60-man ring battle royal World War III to face Hollywood Hulk Hogan. And then all of a sudden he was faced with the idea that Piper had beaten him in the middle. He said, hey, if he can do it, I know at 9 million pounds, I can do it. Going to talk a lot about it.
We are. Evening. Indeed, we're going to talk about it, as well as the Clash and Sold Out. And in fact, Larry, at Sold Out, NWO on pay-per-view, it is the Giant against Hollywood Hulk Hogan. But let's remember, Rowdy Roddy Piper is still in the picture.
Well, you know, the New World Order is making a mistake of gigantic proportions. Piper proved himself to be the true icon. Piper beat Hulk Hogan in the middle of the ring, and there's no doubt in my mind Piper is not going to take the present situation laying down.
So for the first time, we see some dissension within the ranks of the New World Order, and how happy we are to see that. It's a great WCW Pro here on TBS, and we kick it off right now.
I tell you what an eerie way to start off the new 1997, because one of the NWO members, M. Wallstreet, will be coming marching out. But guys, what a 96 it was at Starrcade when Piper put to sleep one Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
You know, that's indications of a good new year for World Championship Wrestling.
Hey, he didn't just defeat him. He humiliated Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Hogan, despite his attempt at rewriting history, probably had his experience in the Soviet Union as a history teacher. He can't deny that Piper beat him.
Put a crack in the foundation and also started dissension in the New World Order.
It surely was nice to see it. A lot to talk about, Dusty. We'll be talking about the Clash of the Champions. Also, NWO Sold Out. Our chance to bring the World Heavyweight title and the Tag Team titles back to WCW. And whoever thought we'd be rooting for the Giant.
Well, we talked a lot about it on the mothership last night, as we talked about the Giant, how he got in that situation. And then, looking at the Hogan Piper thing, I really believe this thing ain't over. I'd love to see this again, although Piper...
Oh! Ryan Kees, 1-2, almost a 3.
Although Piper went out on the Nitro and actually said, you know, goodbye to everybody and thank you very much. I mean, he was on a ride, but I believe deep down he knew it wasn't over. And I guarantee you, when they carried him out, he was talking some foreign tongue, brother. But I guarantee you, I'd like to know what he was talking about.
How about you, Larry? Any insight as to what Piper was saying?
I don't have a clue. I think he was just babbling out in a state of unconsciousness. Just mumbling nothing.
Also, later this month, the new WCW magazine with a very dramatic picture of Sting on the cover. It'll hit newsstands the 28th of January. There's interviews there with Scott Hall, Marcus Bagwell, Eric Bischoff, and a plea for Sting to come back to World Championship Wrestling. Hey, man, we are begging you. We're begging you. Also, a threat, Larry, to you from Scott Hall. He said, look, Zbysko, he said, is great, but he's not as great as he thinks he is.
Well, Scott Hall, what does he know? He's a sheep that follows around DiBiase and Hogan. Right here, another one, you know, look at Wall Street. I wonder how much DiBiase coughed up to get him in the New World Order.
Big bucks.
And Wall Street had money anyway. You know what I mean?
That's a very good point.
So maybe he'd say, maybe trade-off, say, you give me some stocks and bonds of some ideas in this New World Order deal. And they're growing in numbers, but I tell you, they're disarray with what happened at Starrcade. The Giant earned the title shot at World War III, and brother, I guarantee you, it's going to be huge.
That's the Wall Street crash, and them Wall Street from the New World Order victorious in our first match here this week on WCW Pro. Still to come, the Cruiserweight Champion of the World, Ultimate Dragon, and wait till you hear who we've got in the main event. All that and a lot more in a moment.